بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back to my channel QHE تجويد Rules of the Quran channel in English. Today, inshallah, we will start a new chapter which is اللامات السواكن في القرآن الكريم or القرآن العظيم. We have under اللامات السواكن three big categories which is لام الحرف, لام الفعل, and لام الاسم. لام الحرف, we'll talk about it more details on it. لام الفعل means لام in a verb. لام الاسم means اللام in a noun. لام الحرف, we have three other categories under it which is ال التعريف or لام التعريف. We have لام الأمر. And we have لام هل and بل. We will go through each categories of it and explain it with all details about it, inshallah. Let's go here and make one more time لام الحرف clear for you. Number one, we have لام التعريف under it. Second category, لام الأمر. Third category, لام هل and بل. Today, inshallah, we will start to explain لام التعريف. Usually, if you see this one, that means I will explain this one, inshallah, today. هي لام of the definite article. What I mean by that? If I have word like word رجل, like word رجل, let's write it here. رجلز, رجل means any man. Any man. If I say الرجل, that means I'm talking about a specific man. Same thing. If I say for you word كتاب, كتاب means book. Okay? If I say كتاب, I'm talking about any book. But if I say الكتاب, means I'm talking about a specific book. This is what we mean by al at-ta'rif. It's exactly like the in the English. Okay? So what lam at-ta'rif is? It is an extra lam that comes in the first of the nouns to define it. What I mean by that? It's number one, extra lam. How can I tell it's extra lam? Because word rajul, word kitab, it still give meaning if I don't have this al before it. Then it's extra lam. I can take it away and it doesn't affect the meaning of the word. And it's somewhere in nouns only. I will not find it any place except in nouns. This is one of the signs to know this is noun. And if you remember when we explain in Ahkam in Nun Sakina wa Tanween, the rules of Nun Sakina and Tanween, we say another sign to know the nouns. It was the Tanween. Tanween just come in nouns. And al tarif, it just come in nouns in Arabic. And it's preceded by hamzat wasl. What I mean by hamzat wasl? This is the hamzat wasl is. This is how it looks in the Quran. You will find alif with a little sad in top of it. What this hamzat wasl mean? This is mean that we write it, but we don't pronounce it in the connection. So if I connect this alif, it's not there. But if I start with it, I start with as a hamza fatha. Okay, let's go and understand this stuff more and more. Lam at-ta'rif, al. We have two kind under lam at-ta'rif. Depends in the letter is coming after lam at-ta'rif, after this lam. So, I have first category, we call it al-lam al-qamariya, we pronounce it the lam. And the second category is al-lam al-shamsiya, not pronounced the lam. And I choose for you the color orange for al-lam al-shamsiya here, because اللام الشمسية coming from word الشمس And the word الشمس is mean sun in Arabic. So it might be, inshallah, to be in your mind easier way. The rules of اللام القمرية is الإظهار, clear. The rules of اللام الشمسية is الإدغام, merge. The letters of اللام القمرية. If I find L, I should to look for the letter after. If I find one of these 14 letters, I will make إظهار, clear. What's this letter is? The scholars put it for us in that word, إبغي حجك وخف عقيمة. So it's همزة, باء, غين, حاء, جيم, كاف, واو, خاء, فاء, عين, قاف, يا, ميم, and ها. Okay? The letters of اللام الشمسية, the rest of the letters. So I will take word إبغي حجك وخف عقيمة away. The rest of the Arabic letters, it will be لام شمسية. Any letter will follow L. It's not one of the letters of word or of the sentence of إبغي حجك وخف عقيمة. I will count it as لام شمسية and I will not pronounce this لام. Let's take more signs and make it more easy for you. Right now, I will take examples for إبغي حجك وخف عقيمة, اللام القمرية. We have word الأول as an example for همزة, or word الإنسان for as an example to همزة still. So if you look, you will find the لام here ساكنة followed by همزة. I say ال, الأول. So I sound the لام clear. الإنسان, so I sound the لام clear. Example for letter باء is والباطن, وال, والباطن. So I have the لام clear, you can hear it. Example for غين is الغفور, الغفور. So لام, it's very clear too, you can hear it. الحكيم, example for حاء, when it's follow لام التعريف, اللام الساكنة إن التعريف. الجبار, الجبار, you can hear little لام clear. الكبير, you can hear الكبير, you can hear little لام clear. الودود, you can hear little لام clear. الخلق, you can hear letter lam clear when it's followed by خاء letter. Letter فاء now. Remember, I go through each letter of this and I put word as an example for it. Letter فاء is the turn. الفوز. I have lam clear here. العزيز. Lam clear. Letter قاف now. Okay, I put letter ميم here first. It's okay, forgive me. المهاجرين, المهاجرين. So I have لام clear. اليقين, I have لام clear with ياء. القدوس, letter قاف, لام is clear. And the letter ها is the last one here, which is الهدى. If you hear all these words, you will hear لام very clear. طيب, what's the problem here? We will see in the اللام الشمسية how the لام will sound. You will find it disappear, the opposite. So here I pronounce the لام and it's very clear. In اللام الشمسية, I will not pronounce it. What's the sign of الإظهار to لام القمرية in القرآن الكريم? This is how it looks. I will find the همزة الوصل with a little صاد in top of it. And then the لام, it will has سكون of the Quran like that. This is my sign. Example, word القمر. Do you see how it looks? Alif with a little صاد in top of it. And the next لام is with سكون of the Quran. Word, what else? القوم, القوم, same thing. Alif with a little صاد on top of it, and the لام it has سكون of the Quran. So this is a sign of اللام القمرية in the Quran. What's the rule of it? الإظهار. I pronounce it very clear. What's the letter of it? Scholars put it for us in word إبغي حجك وخفع قيمها. Now we will go for اللام الشمسية. We said the letter of it, rest of the Arabic letters. What's the rule of it? الإضغام. What's the words? Let's see examples. الطيب. الط. الط. I didn't say الطيب. I say الطيب. الثواب. I didn't say الثواب. No. I say الثواب. أث. أث. From ألف. From همزة. I go from همزة to ثاء right away. الصفا. الرحيم. التواب. الضر. والذاكرين. والذاكرين. I didn't say والذاكرين. I say والذاكرين. النور. الدعاء. السلام. الظالمين. الزكاة. الشاكرين. And الليل. So this is how the lam sakina, when it's followed with any one of the letters in these words in front of you, I not pronounce the lam at all. I make the shadda in the next letter and I sound the two ta. For example, at-tayyib, at-thawab, as-safa, ar-ra, ar-rahim, at-tawab, الضر والذاكرين النو النور الدو الدعاء الس السلام الظ الظالمين الز الزكاة الشا الشاكرين اللا الليل. So this is how I pronounce the letter after lam if it's one of these letters. So the lam in this case I don't pronounce at all. The rules of it is al-idgham. Why al-idgham? Because the articulation point of these letters are closer, or the articulation point of lam are closer to these letters, and it's the same articulation point with lam. Example of it word al-layl. Inshallah, this is clear for you. Very quickly, what's the letter of Lam al-Shamsiyya? The rest of the letters after I take out the sentence of Ibghi Hajjaka wa Khaf Aqima, which is Lam al-Qamriya. What's the rules of it? Al-Idgham, merge. I make merge between what? Between this Lam Sakina of Al-Ta'rif, this Lam Sakina of Al-Ta'rif, and I merge it with the letter after. Why I merge it? Because these letters all is closer to the articulation point of lam, except the lam, it's the same articulation point with lam. The sign of making idgham to lam shamsiyya in the Quran is when a lam is followed by a shadda on the next letter and the lam has nothing on it. This is very clear sign, very clear sign. If you just remember this sign, you don't have to think about what's the sign of Lam al-Qamariyya. Example, word al-dallin. So what I have here, I have Lam followed by Dad letter, which is Idgham, which is Lam Shamsiyya. Now I have what? I have shadda in the dad and nothing in the lam. In lam qamariya, if you remember, we have sukun here and regular haraka in the next letter. We have some words. There are two opinions for the scholars to make al ta'rif out from it or no. Like what? Like dhal kifl. We can say kifl by itself, and we still can take this lam away or keep it. Like what else? Like Allah. And we explain word Allah more right now, inshallah. After we go for the slides. After this slide. Word Allah. We will explain this word more. And what else? Word Dhannun. Why scholars between two opinion if we can take Alif Ta'rif away or if it's part from the word? Because this word is coming in the Quran with the two ways, with Alif Ta'rif and sometimes it's come without Alif Ta'rif. Like what? Like the Noon. We have Noon. وَالْقَلَمِ وَمَا يَسْطُرُونَ. So we have Noon coming without Alif Ta'rif in the Quran. Word Allah, we will understand the story of it right now and you know where it comes without al tarif. Dal kifl, it's come in the Quran, kifl by itself without al. So that's why the scholars between two opinions. Can we take this al tarif away or we should to keep it all the time and it's a part from the word? What else we have here? We have the words we can't take out al tarif from it. Opposite way. We can't take it out. Like what? Like Asma al-Anbiya, names of some prophets. Al-Asma al-Mawsoola. Al-Asma al-Mawsoola, I will give you examples for it right now, inshallah, so you can know what's Al-Asma al-Mawsoola. This is something in the Arabic grammar. And word Al-An. These three cases, we can take out Al-Tarif from it. Al-Asma al-Mawsoola, like what? Like الذي, التي, اللواتي, اللائي, الذين, اللذين, اللذان, and so on. All these we call it in Arabic الأسماء الموصولة, and we can't take al التعريف from it at all. It's part from this word. Okay, it's still al التعريف. But it's apart from this word. The word we can take out al-ta'rif from it, we say names of a prophet. Which prophet? Al-Yasa'. Prophet Al-Yasa'. This is al-ta'rif, but we still can't take it out because it's apart from this word. Okay? And my last thing, word Al-An. Al-An means now in Arabic. I can't take any tarif from it. Okay, so total, I have some alit tarif, scholars between two opinion if we can take it out or no, which is in three words in the Quran, then noon, then kifl, and Allah. And we have three other cases we can't take alit tarif from it. Which is الأسماء الموصولة, example of it, الذي, التي, اللذان, اللتان, اللائي. Okay, and one of the prophet names, which is اليسع, and my word الآن. I can't take al التعريف from it. Word Allah. Now we explain word Allah and where is al التعريف on it. A lot of people, they are confused and they say word Allah, it has al التعريف. Yes, it has al التعريف. Let's see. This is word Allah, how we have it in the Quran, right? So word Allah, it was coming from word ilah. Arab people in the back, they call ilah. Ilah means God. Okay, any God. So after that, they say al ilah to say this is Allah. To talking about a specific ilah, a specific God. And to make it easy, they say it, now it's al-ilah. To make it easy, they say Allah. One more time. Word Allah, it's coming from word ilah. Ilah means God, any God, even the stones they was pray for it, astaghfirullah, in the back. This is ilah. After that, they put al-ta'rif like the in English to say specific God. So they say al-ilah. To make it easy to themselves when they sound it, they say Allah. So they merge this lamb with this lamb and it's become Allah. So how many lamb we have here in word Allah? Some people think it's three lambs. No, it's just two lamb. This one and that one. And the shadda in the next one. Like any word we took, like word al-dallin. Let's write word al-dallin to remember it. This is word or al-dur. It's more, let's choose maybe black. I hope it's clear. No, it's not. Let's choose what color? Orange, I don't know. It's right here. Word al-dur. If we look here, we will find al-ta'rif followed by dad letter. So dad letter, we have shadda in top of it and nothing in the lam. Same thing. Word Allah, it's like now, like that. Al. Law. And we take this hamza away to make it easy. Not us, the Arab in the back. So what we have here, al-ta'rif followed by the lamb from the word. So I will put shadda here. And this lamb, it will be empty. So how many lamb we have in al-ta'in word Allah? Two lamb, not three. A lot of people, when I ask them this question, they say it's a three lamb. They think this is one and this is two. Yeah, this is one. This is number one. And the second lamb here, it's two lambs. So two and three. So they think this is three. No, it's not three lambs. It's just two lambs in word Allah. Inshallah, this is clear for you. By this, our lesson for today, we explain everything about al-ta'rif. It's very easy. And al-ta'rif, it's under categories of lam al-harf, lam of the letter. Al-ta'rif, it's coming in the beginning of the nouns and it's extra al, except in some al-ta'rif, we can't take it out, like asma al-mawsoola, ladhi, lati, ladhan, latan, or the name of Prophet, which is al-yasa, or word al-an. Al-ta'rif, it has three words, scholars between two opinions to take it out or not, which is word, the noon, the kifl, and word Allah. Why word Allah? We explain it right now. Word ilah, it's come in the Quran by itself, ilah. And it's coming Allah. So it's come in two views in the Quran. That's why scholars between take it out or no. Word the noon. Noon, it's come by itself without al, and it's come then noon, with alif lam. The al-kifl, same thing. That's why scholars between two opinion, if we can take this al-ta'rif away or no. Anything else, al-ta'rif, we can take it and it's extra. We have two kinds of al-ta'rif, al-lam al-shamsiyya, not pronounced, and al-lam al-qamariyya, we pronounced it. And the letters of Lam al-Qamariyya, if I have Lam Sakina, Lam al-Ta'rif al-Sakina followed by Iwi Hajjaka wa Khafa Aqima, one of these letters. In this case, I follow Lam al-Qamariyya and I pronounce the Lam clear. If any other letters, it's not one of them, I follow Lam al-Shamsiyya and I make it not clear and I make merge between this Lam and the letter after and I read the letter after with Shadda. At-Tayyib. الضر. Okay, lam al-amr for today. The lam of the order. Lam al-amr. What's lam al-amr is? هي اللام الساكنة. Then it should to be ساكنة. الزائدة عن بنية الكلمة. ويقع بعدها الفعل المضارع مباشرة وتكون مسبوقة بالواو أو الفاء أو ثم العاطفة. Let's see this by English and explain it. This is the extra lam. Then number one, it should to be extra lam. Number two, it should to be sakina. Then the letter of the original word. followed by present tense and preceded by ثم or فا or وا. Then to know this لام, I should to look for 4 points. To know the لام الأمر, I should to find 3 points. 4 points, I mean. Number one, it should to be extra. Number two, it should to be ساكنة. Number three, it should to followed by present tense. Number four, it should to preceded by فا or ثم or وا. So if I see this 4 point, now I will say this is لام الأمر. So if I imagine this is لام ساكنة here, I should to have before it وا or ثم or فا, and I have to have it after it, I have to have after it present tense. And it should to be extra and ساكنة. Let me explain for you an example here. Let's take word يكتب. يكتب means he's writing. He's writing. يكتب by itself, it's a present tense. It's give a right meaning. No problem on it. To put لام الأمر, this لام الأمر, if I put it before, that's give me لام الأمر meaning. But if I take it away, if I take it away, it doesn't affect the meaning of word يكتب. ليكتب means he will write. He should to be right. It's an order for him to write. Okay? Well, يكتب. To say this is لام الأمر, I should to find وا before, or فل يكتب, or ثم ليكتب. Then I have 4 points I should to look for. Number one, لام ساكنة again. Number two, it should to be واو or فا or ثم before it. Number two, I should to find present tense after it. And it should to be extra, it should to be ساكنة, وا or فا or ثم before, present tense after. Now this is لام الأمر. Another question I heard all the time from non-Arab people, and I understand this question. يعني, and I will try to give you some signs for it. People ask me, how can we know this is present tense in Arabic if we don't understand Arabic? Present tense has a lot of signs in the Arabic to know it, but I will give you one of these signs. It can make it easy to you. Other signs, it's still need to understand Arabic to know it. But this sign right now, it will help you a little or a lot, inshallah. It will help you a lot to know this is present tense. One of the signs, present tense, it should to start with one of these four letters, noon or hamza, and this hamza should to be wrote, or تاء or ياء. Scholars put it for us in word نأتي or word أنيت. So one of my clue to know this is present tense, the present tense start of noon or hamza or ta or ya, and this hamza should to be wrote. Scholars put it in word na'ti or anaitu. Remember that. Right now, I find the present tense. And I look before it, I find the lam sakina. I will look before lam sakina. I will find dua or thumma or fa. Then this is lam amr. Let's see examples here to make it more clear for you. Examples. If I look here, I will find ya in the beginning of this present tense. So this is present tense. You can still use a Google translation or something to know the meaning. By meaning, you can tell this is verb or this is noun or this is what. This is verb, and I can tell it's present tense because it's start with ya. يقضوا means they will do. If I look here before it, I will find لام ساكنة. This lamb is extra. Yes, it's extra because يقضو by itself, it's give meaning. After that, I will look before this lamb. I will find ثم. Then this is what? This is لام الأمر. Another example here. فليستجيبوا. This is example for لام ساكنة. لام أمر ساكنة preceded by فا. يستجيبوا. This is present tense. Means they will listen or they will do what you ask them to do. And this لام is ساكنة. And before it is فا, then this is لام الأمر. وليملل. وليملل. So يملل, it's a present tense. And لام before it is second لام. And if I look before it, I will find letter و. How can I know this لام is extra? I'm not sure this is extra لام. How can I tell this is extra لام? Simple and easy way. Arab can start with second letter? No, they never start with second letter, right? So let's try to start with this لام. ثم is a word. و is another letter different than this word. فليستجيب فا, it's a letter. It's not part from this word. So if I take ثم or فا or و, can I read this word with سكون? No, I can't. That means this is extra لام because Arab never start with second. Arab never start with second. Okay? What's the rules of it is الإظهار وجوبا means you should to make it clear. وليملل فليستجيبوا. This لام it should to be clear. I should to hear it when you read. Especially, and this is my first note, especially when this is لام is followed by تاء, so you don't automatically merge it. Why? Because تاء and لام very close articulation point, very, very close articulation point. So if I'm not focused, some people merge it by mistake and they say, this is example for it. Well, تأتي, some people maybe say, what تأتي? This is wrong. Or فلتقم, some people say it, فلتقم, فلتقم, فلتقم. I should to be very careful, especially if it has the after it. So, example, same one here. And we will say the part of جزرية, شاهد الجزرية. وأولي مثل وجنس إن سكن أدغمك قل ربي وبلى وأب في يوم ما قالوا وهم وقل نعم سبح لا تزغ قلوب فالتقم. If I ask you where is the part of جزرية, it tell me you should to make the لام clear or taking care of لام more when it's followed by تاء. You will choose this وأبن فالتقم. وأبن فالتقم. This is different word. فالتقم, it's different word than فالتقم. But both of them from Quran. Okay? So, لام of the order in the Quran comes all the time with سكون and preceded with ثم or و or ف. And we agree on that in all explanation, right? Except we have exception here. What this exception is, these three verses in the Quran, it doesn't have thumma or wa or fa before it, but it's still lam al-amr. أستأذنكم Surah An-Nur, Ayah 58. كلمة ليقضي علينا. There is no wa or thumma or fa before it, but it's still lam al-amr. It's from Surah Az-Zukhruf, verse 77. لينفق ذو سعة من سعته. This is still lam al-amr, and it doesn't have thumma or fa or wa. What else you see here? This lam, it's lam al-amr, but it's with kasra. So I can start with it. This is how it's come in the Quran in these three verses. This is still lam al-amr, but it's not sakina, and it doesn't have thumma or fa or wa. And this is extra information for you. My main rule, I should to find wa or thumma or fa, and it should to be sakina, and it should to followed by present tense. But just in these three exceptions, it's not sakina, and it doesn't have thumma or fa or wa before it, but it's still lam al-amr. There is another note here. If the reader begins with a verb like thumma liyaqadu, he will start with kasra, because Arab never start with sukun. Don't do this in purpose, since it should not to be used in normal reading. You can't start liyaqadu by itself, by yourself. But if I ask you how you read this word, you will show me, you will put kasra under this lam. But without the teacher ask you for that, you can't separate thumma from liyaqadu. You can't separate walyumlil from liyumlil. Okay, and so on. Lam, hal, and bal. Let's go together and see what's lam, hal, and bal. If you look here, you will find this word of hal, ha, then this is fatha, and this is lam sakina. Bal, this is fatha, and this is lam sakina. So what's the rules of hal and bal? And why we put it under lam al-harf? This is harf in the Arabic. Hal and bal, we count it as a letter in Arabic. We count it as a harf in Arabic. So, in the grammar of Arabic. So let's go together and see what lam, hal, and bal is. هي اللام الساكنة الواقعة في هل and بل. It's the lam sakina in word hal or bal. We count it letter in grammar in Arabic. But we can still say it word, okay? حكمها, the rules of it, الإظهار وجوبا إلا إذا وقع بعدها لام أو راء فيجب الإدغام وتقع اللام بعدها هل وبل أما الراء فلم تقع بعد هل. Let's see this by English. Should to make it clear, إظهار. This lam in هل and بل, you should to make it clear, إظهار, except if it is followed by مثلها means lam, another lam, or letter ra. This case, you should to make it merge, idgham. So in all the cases of hal and bal, lam of hal and bal, I make idghar on it. I make it clear, except if I have ra after it, or if I have lam after it. In this case, I make merge. Note. Lam comes after hal and bal, but ra never comes after hal. So the lam, you can find it after word hal or after bal, both. But letter ra never comes after hal, it just comes after bal in the whole Quran. Examples, halakum, halakum. This is example for merge. هل لكم بلا بلا يخافون بر رفعه بر بر رفعه. I don't say بل رفعه, I say بر بر رفعه. إن شاء الله this is clear. We have in سورة المطففين one exception here in Hafs way, which is بل ران. This lam, it should to be clear. I should to say bal ran. I don't make merge here. Why? Because I have sakt. What sakt mean? I stop between the lam and the ra. I pass between them for a second without taking any breath. So I stop in, or I pass in letter lam for a second, and I don't take any breath between. So بل ران. بل ران. I don't say بر ران. No. In half sway, I should to make this lam izhar here. Even if there is ra is coming after it. Inshallah, this is clear too. The reason of idgham, التماثل مع اللام والتقارب مع الراء. Same articulation point with lam and the closer articulation point with ra. Hal end with lam. And the next word, if it's a start with lam, I make merge. Why? Because they are the same articulation point, so it's easier to make idgham on it. Why with ra? Because they are closer articulation point together. By this, our lesson for today is done. It's a very simple and easy lesson. So alhamdulillah, we're done with all kind of lam al-harf. Next time, inshallah, we will talk about lam al-fa'l. Jazakumullahu khairan. To watch my channel, QHE, Tajweed Rules of the Quran channel in English. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.